Through the millenniums, God has used mortals to show his power on the earth. In every generation, he has sought to find individuals that he could use to do the unimaginable. To show that power is not in numbers or skill, that victory is not attained by earthly strength, but that the humblest and simplest of persons could do mighty feats and accomplish humanly impossible tasks by simply putting their trust in him and letting him work through them. It was not a military commander, but a shepherd that delivered Israel from Egypt. It was not a muscle-bound giant, but a weakling named Samson that destroyed the Philistine temple. Nor was it an experienced warrior, but a farmer that defended his property by killing 600 Philistines. It is the small and simple things that God uses to defeat what man calls mighty. It is the foolish things that God uses to confound the wise. In our own day, God has made victory so attainable, so within our grasp, that we often reach beyond it and miss it, blinded by its simplicity. It does not take strength to be mighty, or skill to achieve victory, nor great numbers to conquer. All it takes is faith.
Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord, so much for another day to be alive, Lord, and to serve you in.
I don't know what today holds, but I know you hold the day. Give me the strength to overcome.
Lord bless you. Good morning, friends.
Another great event that I wouldn't forget to call. That was when David was in his worst of time. Those warriors that was with David stayed right by his side. If a Philistine come up, he had to fight. Whoever it was, they were picked on every side. Poor David in his mind, all confused, he thought, how can it be, Lord? It's right. In the heat of the battle here, David began to think, oh, I can remember them nights I laid out yonder on that hillside. When God was with me, I sang his praises, I enjoyed him. I remember when I sang his praises in my childhood days when I heard in my sheep, oh God, take me back to that place. Take me back to my first love. That sometimes we think that, but we're in the heat of the battle. Something's got to be done. We were boys once, we're a grown up man now. The fight's on. Then his mind goes back to way down there by the gates of Bethlehem.
Amen.
There was a well. There just was no water like that water.
Hallelujah.
Oh, if I only had a drink of water!
Guys, warriors, and he screamed out in his despair, oh, if someone would bring me a
drink again. From that old well yonder at Bethlehem. Now his warriors cannot interpret his thinking. But brother, they loved him with all that was in him. The least of his desires was a command to him.
All right, old man. Let's see what you got.
You ready to go to school, son? Okay, all right. Is that all you got? Is that a Tonka toy you got? When are you going to trade that in for a real sword?
Show you. Huh? What you got?
Okay. I'll keep it in first gear.
Yeah, wipe that sweat, old man. Think fast, old man.
You disappoint me. We're throwing rocks now? Come on, Shama. You know I'm better than you. Not even tired yet.
Oh, yeah. I can tell. Guys, that was pathetic. Never seen such horrible fighting. You know what? When you guys really want to know how to fight, come see me. Flesh, they stumbled and fell. Though a host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise against me,
In this will I be confident.
For in the time of trouble, he will hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle will he hide me. He will set me up upon a rock.
David, Saul's army has been spotted.
And the Philistine army is in the Valley of Rephaim. They have garrisoned at Bethlehem.
That means all communication between Jerusalem and Bethlehem has been intercepted.
What do you want to do?
Wait. Wait on the Lord. I can't do anything until I know what he wants me to do.
What's wrong?
Feeling sorry for myself.
You know, I've been thinking a lot lately of how things used to be. So close with God. I knew what he wanted me to do and I did it. Now there just seems to be so many questions. I don't know where to turn.
But things are different now.
The battle is on now. Now it's time to fight. Perhaps God is the one waiting on you.
Yes, I suppose. Oh, Bethlehem. Oh, I would love to have a drink of the water from the well of Bethlehem. Someone could just bring me a drink of that sweet, cool water.
How far is it to Bethlehem?
15 miles, round trip. And how many Philistines stand between us and the well? A lot. Give or take a few thousand.
Oh.
Got the bucket? Yep.
All right, man. Let's go get the enemy and get our king a drink of water.
Philistines took Bethlehem. They killed men, women, and children. The people of Bethlehem didn't stand a chance.
Sounds like the kind of party I like to break up.
Whoa, 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 whoa. What have we here?
What do you think? About half a dozen?
This can be a piece of cake.
Yeah, that'd be no problem.
Yeah, and I bet you wouldn't even get tired.
That's not funny.
Only to the Lord.
Every Philistine is your Lord. You guys.
gentlemen! Can I have this dance? Shama, hope you like leftovers. Enjoy. Excuse me. Looking for some Philistines?
You found them.
Wait. Can't be you. I was told that the Philistines are rough and tough. Big, bad, and buff. I could take you without even breaking a sweat.
Hey, little sister, not so bad after all, are we? Hey, look, I need to pass along a little message to your general. I need you to tell him to remove all troops out of Bethlehem. And there's going to be a bloodbath that he won't believe. We're on a special mission here. We don't need to be dealing with any Philistines. Do you get it?
Mm-hmm. Who are you?
No one.
You're with David! I feel the presence of Jehovah. Anyone that's with David, Jehovah is with them.
First attack was here, and then they started picking off our men like flies in this region here. What's confusing me is the direction they seem to be heading.
They could be headed to the supply fort in the southern quarter if they can.
That's in the opposite direction.
There's nothing in the opposite direction. How many are there?
Three.
100?
Just three.
Perhaps they're headed to a different province altogether, and Bethlehem is just a good shortcut.
Not on your life. They wouldn't cut through an entire army just to take a shortcut. How do you know there's just three?
Trust me, there's only three. But they're good. Too good. They've already killed some of my best men. First, they were just attacking small bands, protecting the outlying areas of Bethlehem. But as they gained further ground, they started growing more and more brazen. Attacking companies of 50, hundreds at a time. They attack so fast that most of our men are dead before they even know what hits them.
It's as if they attack supernaturally.
What is of importance in the direction that they're heading?
The only thing of importance in that area is a well.
The well.
Are you sure you're up to this?
You are getting a little up there in age.
What? What are you talking about?
I saw Lance come this close to your head today, bro. You're getting slow.
Oh, okay, I can see where this is going. Look, you just worry about the bucket, water boy. And leave the rough stuff to the quarterbacks. I'll worry about my head.
I have a hard time distinguishing the difference.
Oh, hilarious. Hilarious. You just remember where you got your training, buddy, and I can knock you out of the ring any day of the week.
And I bet you wouldn't even get tired.
That's right.
Maybe getting a little too comfortable here.
Go check for survivors. Go put that fire out. Was it the three? I'm not gonna tell the general this. He's gonna think I'm a fool.
Come on, ladies, are we dancing or fighting? Let's go.
I got something for you.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, come on. That's pathetic.
I think you dropped something.
My little sister fights harder than that.
Oh, yeah.
I got something for you.
Let's see.
Yeah. Come on, that's pathetic. Let's go. Come on, you bunch of sissies. Let's go. Come on, baby. You need your diapers changed or what? Come on. Let's go. Need your diaper change?
Okay, I'll catch you lunch for you.
And remember I told you, I could take you any day of the week.
It is obvious at this time that these are some of David's legendary warriors. They have attacked by surprise and have hunted our men down like animals. It has been reported that each of these men have killed several hundred of our men in previous battles. So we have given orders to recall every soldier from every quarter of Bethlehem. And we shall see how well these three defend themselves when we are ready and waiting for them. So men, you have one mission. Surround that well.
You are your own worst enemy. No one knows your weaknesses like you do. You are the one that opens the door to your weaknesses or closes the door and rejects it. So if you go into battle focusing on your weaknesses, you're already lost. The outcome of the fight is up to you. If all you see is your weaknesses, that's all your enemy will see. And he will mark those weaknesses. He'll study them and eventually destroy you by them. Defense is good. We need it. But if defense is all you know, you will never be able to end the fight. When you enter the fight, you cannot go by what you feel or what you think. And you have one objective, and that's I'm going to win. You can't lose. There's no way of losing. Not because you feel it, not because you think it, but because that is the only acceptable outcome. There is no negative. There is no fear. There is no doubt. There is only victory. Victory is not a feeling. It's not an emotion, nor a thought. It is a state of being. So take your faith and cut your way through every doubt.
Let's get out of here.
We got what we came for.
General, the three, they've broken through our lines.
Where are they heading now?
They seem to be heading back the way that they came. They got what they came for.
And what was that?
You wouldn't believe me if I told you.
I'm impressed. Now I believe everything that they've said about you three.
Who are you supposed to be?
I am that thing in your life that you just can't seem to overcome.
Yeah, what's going on with your outfit? Yeah,
You're so ugly you have to wear that mask?
Look, pal, we've had a long day, and we get pretty cranky when we're tired. So how about we do this? You go home to Mama while you still have a chance. Because let me tell you, if you stick around, it's not going to be pretty. We go on, you stay alive. That sound fair?
This doesn't have to be painful. I just want that water.
Man, you must be as crazy as you look.
You can kill my soldiers. You can wipe out my entire army. You can even kill me. But I will die with a smirk on my face, knowing that I stopped you from getting what you came for. It's not he who starts the race. It's he who finishes that gets the reward. It's one thing to get it, and it's another thing to keep it.
Okay. Come and get it.
Let me at him.
Whoa. Wait a minute. Guys. Calm down. All right, okay. Make it quick.
Okay. Spank him, Ellie.
Uh-oh.
up on me! Face me! Fight me like a man!
I attack you that way because that is the way your enemy attacks. He is a coward and he will never look you in the face.
Who are you?
What you need to know is who you are. You will never be able to defeat your enemy if you don't know who you are and what power you possess.
Let me go. I'm not gonna let you go till you teach me how to fight.
That is exactly the attitude that'll get you somewhere.
Service tonight.
Daddy, we missed you at church tonight.
Dad, you want to know what I learned in Sunday school today?
You've missed 3 services in a row.
Daddy, I miss how things used to be.
Mommy, why doesn't Daddy pray with us anymore?
What would you do if you came home and everything you loved was gone? I don't even know if I know you anymore.
I'm praying for you, Daddy.
The kids really want to spend more time with you.
Daddy, now do you have time for me?
Show. It's called Living with a Christian That's Too Saved.
Ouch! Remember when we used to be too saved?
Boy, do I ever.
What holier-than-thou attitudes we had.
I know! When we thought it was wrong to go to the theaters, and we didn't even believe in owning the television.
Who in this day could even think about not owning a television? And when was it that we really first started seeing the light?
I think it was around the time when we didn't feel it was necessary to go to evening services if we were too tired.
Oh man, did things ever start to change after that? Why, hey, you remember when we got our first movie rental car?
Yeah, and we exhausted the family section at the rental store in the first 2 weeks.
And then we moved on to PG comedies?
Which led to PG-13 thrillers.
Woohoo! I'm so glad that we're not too saved anymore.
Yes. Yeah, just think of all the things we were missing out on.
Right. Of course, the kids have had a few problems.
I know. And they were such good kids, too.
True. And I was hoping that Ricky Jr. would be an assistant pastor one day.
Well, you never know. He still could be one someday.
Right. Yeah, he'd make a really good one, babe. If he could stay out of jail long enough.
True. And Darla?
Oh, Darla. Now that is another story.
Where did we go wrong with her?
Well, I remember she wanted to go to that church camp really bad, and we wouldn't let her go.
Well, I know, but she seemed to have a really fun time with us at Disneyland instead.
Yeah, but she really had her heart set on going to that camp.
Yeah, I know. Now we can't even get her to go to Sunday service with us.
You know, the kids used to be really good Christian kids. When did they start to change?
When we started to change.
You mean when we decided to no longer be too saved?
Maybe we should have kept the kids in church and taught them that the Lord was more important than movies and ball games.
And Wednesday night services are more important than your favorite TV show.
Don't worry, I'm your best friend. You can trust me. There's no friend like me. I'm there for you all the time. Just whenever you need me, I'm here. I won't let anything happen to you.
Never better fight your enemy the way you fight. You just mess everything up trying to fight your own way. You've got to learn how to fight like God fights.
That?
Not good.
Why?
Because
you left the simple things left undone.
Nothing to worry about. I'm here for you. I'll look out for you. Me and you were best pals.
Don't try to get all fancy with some impressive move. If it doesn't take down your enemy, it doesn't matter how good it looks. Remember, God works in simplicity. If you go overboard and fail to remember the simple things, your enemy will take you and your great revelation down. Don't dishonor the great things by forsaking the small things. Faith! Faith! Grace! Faith! My cross! Much better! Now let's put your training to the test. This is now the real deal. Trust completely in your training, it will do the fighting for you. Don't try to do it your way. He will keep you fighting all night long if you do it your way. His objective is to wear you out. Your objective is to kill him.
I killed you already.
I guess I don't die so easily.
That's okay. Nothing wrong with getting knocked down. As long as you get right back up.
He's stronger than I.
That doesn't matter. It has nothing to do with strength. It has to do with faith.
He's got more experience than me.
You're thinking the way man thinks. Stop it. It's not about you. It's about your faith in God.
I don't think I can do this.
You don't have to do it. Jesus already did it for you. All you have to do is believe that. Quit focusing on you. You asked me to teach you how to fight, and I am. You don't fight by saying you can't do it. You fight by telling yourself you can do it. You don't fight by confessing your faith is weak. You fight by confessing it is strong. Our weapons are not carnal, but spiritual to the pulling down of strongholds.
Why does it seem so impossible?
You're trying to reason your circumstance, son, and you can't do that. Reason is what he's hitting you with. It is your enemy. His weapons are fear, doubt, depression, sickness, symptoms. Your weapon is that faith in God has overcome all that, so you don't have to. Stop fighting this man as though you're already defeated. Instead, fight him with the realization that he's defeated. Jesus already conquered him at Calvary. Now he's hitting you with doubt, you hit him with faith. He hits you with depression, you hit him with joy. He hits you with defeat, you hit him with victory. Do the opposite of what he wants you to do. Allow me to demonstrate.
Please.
Faith. Faith. Grit. Faith. My cross. Low stomach. Uppercut. Now you're on your own.
What do I do now?
Listen to the voice.
What? What?
Listen to the voice.
What voice?
Because you got so many voices in that head of yours. You've been listening to every other voice. Now concentrate real hard and you'll hear the voice.
Get you on the floor and then train for the knockout punches. because you're going to have to use them. Everybody knows that. You have to train to hit your enemy. Always God uses his word. We must remember that
it.
God uses his word to defeat his enemy.
So bad, was it? Come on. No. You're stronger than that. I won't let anything happen to you.
Wait a minute. You say you're my friend. You ain't saying nothing. You seem to be my worst enemy.
He's got to come in your mind first, and you have to accept it. It can batter against you, but it can't get to you until you accept it. See, it's your mind that opens up the door or closes the door and listens to your conscience, listens to your memory, listens to your affections. But when your mind closes itself to these things and let God, the Spirit of His Word, come in, it blows the rest of the stuff out.
What are you doing?
Giving the man a chance to get up.
Why?
It's only fair.
Really? You know, that's one of the biggest mistakes believers make when they get the victory over something. They feel secure and think it's time to relax while the devil's getting back up. Are you gonna give that cancer a chance to get back up? Are you going to give that depression a chance to get back up? Are you going to give that doubt a chance to get back up? What about that addiction God delivered you from? Are you going to give that a chance to get back up? We're not playing a game here, son. It's a fight to the death. Your goal is to beat the devil every chance you get to make sure he doesn't get back up. If you truly want the victory in your life, quit babying the things that trouble you and get over there and beat the life out of them while you got the chance. Hurt the devil's feelings.
Thank you.
disappointing, isn't it? You really thought you'd killed me, but I seem to keep hopping up. Go ahead and kill me. I'll be here next time around. You have wished to get out of the same old routine for years, but I will never leave you alone. You inherited me. You've tried here, you've tried there, and I've gotten you every time. See, it proves that you're not his. You can rebuke me, you can fight me with the sword, but when you're done with your little victory dance, I'll still be here, waiting for the next time you come around.
Lord God, please help me. How can I fight this?
Don't punch at it. Don't punch it. Punch a snake, just keep saying, I rebuke you, he'll bite you. Just ignore him, walk away from him. No, he's defeated anyhow, so there you go. Just don't punch at him. Say, oh, Lord, rebuke him, rebuke him. Don't do that. See, you're weakening what you really believe. Lay the thing on the altar and believe God that the thing is dead and you'll never have it no more, and go on and don't even pay any attention to it no more, and the thing will leave you. Resist the devil and he will flee from you. That's get away quickly. So that would be my advice, how to overcome it. We overcome the devil by faith. That's what we overcome all evils by faith.
What are you doing? What are you... Pick up that sword. Pick up that sword and fight me. Rebuke me, you fool. Fight me. You coward, I curse you. Do something about it. Fight me!
I am.
Wonder if the warriors today are willing to cut their way through formalism, doubts, and unbelief to refresh in the presence of the Lord his desires. The least of your desires, if it's Africa, India, if it's to the street, wherever it is, the least of your desires, Lord, is my command. Death don't mean a thing to me.
Oh, you Bethlehem dwellers! Hallelujah! Call from man warriors who's not afraid. I don't care if these 800 standing on one side and 10,000 on the other. I want warriors who will come with me and cut a hole through this line of unbelieving Philistines. The world council has got the garrisoned around the word of God, trying to make it creeds and feed the people. There's a well. There's a fountain open in the house of David. Bethlehem! For sin and uncleanness, brother, sin is unbelief in his word. Who warrior that can see the millennium coming? What warrior can see this great Holy Spirit coming in the form of Jesus Christ, the literal body of Christ to take over again? Stand with me. Stand by me. Let's cut a hole through this denominational creed. Let's get in there. He's crying for a good fresh drink of Pentecostal water.
Hey, brother.
Good morning.
Good morning.
God bless you. How are you?
I'm ready for church.
Hey, man.
How was your morning?
Yep, brother, my morning was very interesting.
Really?
Very
so
interesting.
So was mine.
God bless you, brother.
God bless you,
my brother.
Good morning.
Good morning to you.
Good morning, brother. God bless you. All right, man. Let's go get the enemy and get our king a drink of water.
Yeah! Yeah!